Hey guys, Kevin. Today I'm going to explain to you how to change the ink lines for DTFPro Model J. It was shot in the lab, so there'll be some background noises. At first, let me explain how the wiring works. Then I will show you a video how it's done. So we have a white ink bottle and has three outlets, 1, 2, 3. And on the bottom, we have an ink pump that pumps ink. I will use the red color for the tubes that go towards the printer. So from the outlet number 2, we go to the pump, and from the pump, we split into two lines. When those two lines reach the printhead, before the printhead, it goes to damper 1 and damper 2, those two white dampers. Let me use the blue to mark the splitters. So you need two splitters, one for damper 1, one for damper 2. Then you have another splitter at the pump. For the return line, you have a return line number 1 goes to outlet number 1, and you have return line number, I'll call it number 3, goes to the number 3. I don't know how many joints those guys smoked before come up with this interesting design. You can see it could take 4 lines on the ink system, so it put a lot of heavy stress on the printed carriage, and that's where I see most of the repairs come from. And next, Abby going to show you a real example.
Hey guys, it's Abby here. I'm going to be explaining and showing how I replace the ink tubes on this printer. So at the top of this printer, sitting on top, is this white bottle, and that's where we had a lot of white ink in there. The white ink tends to clump up, so I needed to go ahead and clean out that bottle, and I put distilled water in there, and we flushed out a lot of the ink tubes, the white ink tubes, but we just had to replace them. So there's a pump that sits under all of the colored ink, and that's where I'm putting that new tube and connecting it from the pump back up to this top bottle. Originally I connected it to the number 1 spot, but it's really supposed to go to number 2, so I'll change that later on in the video as we see, but originally right now I'm just trying to get the rest of the tubes now from out of this area so we can take them out. So here you just see me working the rest of these tubes out of the space. But you also see here there's a little zip tie almost back in this area. So that's what's holding them all down, and I'm just pulling it out of that space. So almost free, and now they're free from here. But not completely, because they also run the back length of the printer under the colored tubes. So now I am unscrewing the dampers at the end of the tubes that will then go into the printhead. So the reason I'm cutting my tubes is because it is near impossible to just pull off the tubes from the connecting spots. There's these little Y connectors, and I cut it as close as I can to the connection spot, and then I'll use the dental tool that we talk about a lot. You can get it for pretty cheap on Amazon, and I use the dental tool to just get as close as from where I cut it, like at the connection spot here, and I stick it under there and I just pull up, and it basically just rips off, not rips off, but it just sticks on there and I can pull that off. So here's a close-up shot of where the tubes go in to connect with the dampers. At first I thought it was every other slot. You can see like blue space, red space, but when I tried to do it that way, it didn't work out accordingly. So really, just you don't have to follow, unless you saw how it went in before. I guess I didn't pay close enough attention to it. Now I'm working these 4 clear tubes, which will be the white tubes going back. When I took them out, I saw that they were under the colored tubes, the yellow, black, magenta, and cyan. So that's what I'm doing, is I'm placing them back under them, under this long black coil type thing. But so that's where I'm feeding that back into, and it wasn't super easy because you can see that there's like slots that follows it, but I just worked it along slowly and got it. And then here's that part, as I was talking, like that zip tie that just ties the tubes into place. Once I got it, then I just put that under there and pulled them through, just working it slowly under there. You don't have to do everything all at once. As long as you just work it through, it'll pass fine. And as you can see, the tubes in the back are just coming through. All right, and so now we have our farthest tubes, and they're still all connected. At this point, I needed scissors just to help me cut the ends of the tubes a little bit for me to separate them with my fingers. So here I wasn't able to pull them apart. At that point, it's fun because it just feels like you're pulling Twizzlers apart or something, but I like that part of it. Anyways, so here again, that's where I needed to use the dental tool to pull off the last bit of tubing on the connection pieces. Let's see. Now that I got the tubing free, it is time to go ahead and connect to that pump at the bottom. If I can remember correctly, the way we did it was that the middle two went down into that pump at the bottom, and the outside two went in to the top. And as you can see here now, I corrected, if you look at the top bottle, I corrected it to it being the middle, that middle one goes to number two, as you can see there. So I accidentally cut the tubes a little bit short, so I'm gonna go ahead and have to fix this again. But as you can see, it was pretty easy. But when you put it in, the two middle tubes go to the bottom pump and the outside two tubes go to the top bottle. So happy printing, everyone. I hope this was helpful.
I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at www.bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.